your boy Indian Guru in the house, back with another bang on video. Well, another video wherein I'll, you know, pounce all on the Arsenal news that is coming your way. So make no mistake, be a part of this channel by subscribing to this channel and hit that bell icon so you get notifications whenever we post a video on YouTube. Yes, we come daily on YouTube and we post daily stuff, all the news that that is coming your way, you know, from the Arsenal Football Club. And most importantly, this is not a channel, this is a community. I always keep telling this as a channel. This is a community for all the Arsenal fans to join in and shoot in whatever their comments are, shoot in whatever they feel about Arsenal post-match. This channel has pre-match previews, post-match previews. We have the statistics that's coming your way. We do the build-up to the every game that's coming our way. Obviously, whichever the game is coming at the weekend, we do the build-up straight away from the very next game's day. We make sure that we don't stop at it. And we have two important concepts, the POV, the point of view, number one. And number two, the most important thing that we actually speak about is roast of the week every Friday. So we roast especially any person that any person, team, or whatever the concept that comes in. Well, without any further ado, let's move on with the video. Let's start the video. But first, at the beginning, again, the plastic fans of the Premier League, Chelsea fans, have against racially abused Kurt Zouma because there was an own goal in the last game that they played against Sheffield United. You guys are so pathetic and so harmful for all the football fraternity. I really don't understand. See, these may be very few people, and I'm really talking to those kind of people who despise Chelsea, even though they support Chelsea, but in quite a negative way. They go as far as even, you know, racially abusing any of your own players. Why? Just to show that you want to hurt somebody, because they should feel the same amount of pain that you do. I'm sorry to say. See, yesterday's match, I think Napoli versus Juventus. Yeah, Juventus were leading 3-0. Napoli came from behind to draw almost 3-3. It was almost 91.1 minutes where Miralem Pjanic got a free kick. He kicked the ball and Koulibaly accidentally put in his own net. So now what should Koulibaly wait for? Racial abuses from Napoli? No! That's the love for your player. It should be irrespective of the color. What is wrong with you guys? Kurt Zouma, even though if he does not remain a part of Chelsea, if he goes somewhere else, he will be respected everywhere he goes because he's a great talent. And I do not expect any player in football racially abused just because his performance was bad. Okay, one performance was bad. Well, probably his next performance will be much, much, much better. Then what? You guys will suck his dick? I really don't understand what kind of plasticity or what kind of fakeness that you guys come up with, that you cannot support, you cannot stand still with your team. That's exactly what has been wrong with you guys. That is exactly what is wrong with you guys, you Chelsea team's management as well. But why do I care? The only thing is that I want to raise my voice against racism. Whenever it comes my way or whenever I come to know about anything, I'll definitely raise my voice. Let's move on with the first news of the day. That is Robert Pires. Robert Pires was seen during the training of the Arsenal at the Arsenal training grounds. Well, this is one of the images that you can see. Yes, it is great to have one of the biggest legends of Arsenal Football Club coming to the team during the week of the North London Derby. Well, during the year of the North London Derby, if you see Robert Pires, it's really great. But if you guys have seen that Arsenal in the YouTube channel used to put more and more and more training videos, you know, before the matches, they used to put more and more training videos, the more and more on-field sessions, but they're not showing that. They're not doing that since I don't know, I've not seen, probably in 2 weeks time, I've not seen their videos coming up. So most probably there's something wrong, maybe, but let's see what's gonna happen. Let's move on with the next and very interesting and exciting news for every Arsenal fan right now. Real Madrid will be sending their scouts during and they will be watching Ceballos versus Tottenham, just so that after that, if they believe that Ceballos performs a very great deal of match, they are expecting a stratospheric offer from Arsenal. That clearly means, this is one of the sources. Well, we don't confirm it yet. But if that's the case, that clearly means that Real Madrid are looking to sell Ceballos. But definitely not at a very high, not at a very low price, because stratospheric prices, obviously, he's a good talent. I really agree, because I think as per the reports, during this season itself, his price was somewhere around 40 to 45 million, and definitely Real Madrid is definitely trying to coop 70 million here. And I believe if Ceballos gets a very positive whole season, I'm going to judge Ceballos on a whole season. It is promising. Towards from the start to the season to the end of the season, I will be considering Ceballos as a promising talent. Only after the first season with Arsenal, I can expect him whether he can be bought or not. Other than that, after seeing one performance and seeing the other performance being bad, I'll not judge what Ceballos brings for the table for Arsenal's future. That's what we all are striving for. That's what the management is striving for, Arsenal's future. Let's move on. The next news of the day, Mohamed Elneny. Mohamed Elneny had a very long and very cute message to all the Arsenal fans since he left for the Turkish giants, Beşiktaş. He had this to say: I am very excited to be joining Turkish giants Beşiktaş. I look forward to achieving our targets in the Super League. Well, they are the Super League team. And Europe. Well, to my dear Arsenal fans and teammates, I wish all the success for the season, and I'll be sure to be following the team's progress from Istanbul. Well, that's really cute, Mo. That's really, really cute of you, and you are definitely, whenever you're given a chance, you are definitely providing your best. It's just that your best was the worst ever performance for any player during the match at the pitch for Arsenal. Well, That's exactly what a symbol of mediocrity that you were on the pitch. But nonetheless, that is like being brutally honest. But to not take away the goodness that you have in your heart, well, thank you so much, Mo, and we'll definitely look forward to your success as well. Because the more you succeed, the more are the chances of you joining Beşiktaş on a permanent transfer, we're getting that 18 million, and we can definitely make good use of that money, isn't it? Well, let's move on to Lee Dixon. Lee Dixon has come up with some gems actually, and we all definitely missed it during the Liverpool game. Well, when Andy Townsend and Lee Dixon had a chat, well, after the post-match of Arsenal versus Liverpool, well, Andy Townsend was actually talking about when Arsenal had a throw-in and Aubameyang was going for the throw-in, and that's exactly when he saw that certain instructions, the three coaches of Arsenal, they were throwing some instructions at Aubameyang, and he heard them and he came back. And Lee Dixon, on agreeing to that factor, he said, he had this to say to Andy Townsend: you're absolutely right, because already there's three people up there shouting things. There needs to be calmness. It's a throw-in. They've lost the ball. Coaches give information, and you know you've played at the highest level. You know most of the stuff that gets shouted from the sidelines, so you don't listen to it. Well, that's really cool. That's really cool, because he wants calmness. It's completely agreed, because that's a tense situation. You always want calmness at that situation. And most importantly, Lee Dixon here tells everybody that through this medium network, that's what he's saying, that Unai Emery and the coaches, they know that something is wrong when the system is planned, when the whole tactics is planned and it's been devised and it's been told to the players to play that way, and when they don't, and when something does not pan out like that, whenever you get close to one player, it's not that you are going to shout the same instructions to all the 11. You cannot do that, because the coaches and the managers are the one side of the pitch. So whoever comes closer, they try to remind them. And obviously it's like, oh yeah, I know that. That's the scenario where Aubameyang would have been in. But I completely believe that. And I really believe that. I think obviously, like Ole Gunnar Solskjaer, you have to be calm in one way, but not exactly the way the results are coming for them. It's definitely a doomsday for Manchester United's hopes of finishing the top four. It's definitely a struggle, and they are definitely entered that struggle. It's just because Jose Mourinho was there and they did not capitalize on that same kind of future. But most importantly, Jose Mourinho knows that the situation at Manchester United is shit, down to the dumpsters. And it's definitely not going to improve in the soon, because I think Arsenal have been in that, and I have hopes that top four definitely looks quite brighter. I'm not really into it, Because this was a transfer window where everybody can right now criticize Unai Emery because he got the money, he got the players that he wanted, and definitely he has to turn it around right now. This is his season, this is his make or break season, and he has to turn it around. If he does not, he will definitely be blamed. Well, let's move on with the next news. Well, next news, we have a news wherein we tell you all about the team news, the injury news. Basically, we have the injury list right now. Number one, Rob Holding. Rob Holding is in on-field rehabilitation, finished 90 minutes for the under-21s game recently and looks really good. Moving on to Emile Smith Rowe. Emile Smith Rowe, well, played 80 minutes against Everton under-21s, played 90 minutes against Northampton Town and looks really positive. Hector Bellerin is under on-field rehabilitation, progressing well and looks to join in September full training with the team. Kieran Tierney also an on-field rehabilitation for him, well, progressing really well, and September is expected to join full training with the team. That means in September, well, just let this game be the best game for us, and when we do believe that we win against Tottenham today, we move on into the international break, and that's exactly when you see both of our fullbacks coming back to full training, and that is greatest news that you guys can definitely have. Let's move on to Dinos Mavropanos. Well, the treatment is ongoing for his problems, but his aim is to return to full training in September as well. So everyone, make no mistake, this September we are definitely going to get almost a great boost in terms of the players' arrivals in the defensive department. We are definitely sure going to miss Nacho Monreal, and I really wish the whole of success that he can for his 2 years with Real Sociedad. All the best for him. All I can say right now is we should get Kieran Tierney as soon as possible, and we are definitely going to show everybody who are the best fullbacks in the whole of Premier League, and it's definitely not Trent Alexander-Arnold and Ali Robertson. I believe that we can definitely have Hecky Bellerin and definitely Kieran Tierney in that most important spot in the defense that we should that we were missing actually. Well, without any further ado, I'll definitely try to remind you guys that today is Arsenal versus Tottenham. Yeah, in India it's the timing is at around 9 p.m. at night, but you guys will definitely have it in the evening, and make sure to support the team and make sure that you get behind our boys, and we know that it's the biggest game of the whole of the season. First, at the Emirates, it's always the biggest. As a Tottenham Hotspur fans, stadium, I don't give a damn about it. But this game is the biggest, and make sure you support our team. Make sure you watch the game, and make sure that you guys, after the game, I'll definitely put a community tab post. Definitely come on to that and say whatever you guys can after the game. So make no mistake, be a part of this channel, be a part of this community, subscribe, and raise your voice for Arsenal. I'll see you in my next video. Cheers.